Dear students, today I am going to discuss about the topic sources of energy. We all are familiar about the energy. What is energy? And we can define energy as capacity to do the work in general way. Okay, that means if we are requiring power, or if we are consuming some power for a particular time, then it is called as energy in terms of electrical terms. So what I would say, energy is the product of power and time. Different kind of energy is available in the environment. That is called solar energy, wind energy, fuel energy, electrical energy, mechanical energy. But today I am going to discuss about the only electrical energy. Importance of electrical energy, or we can say how this form of energy is superior than the other forms of energy. So for that purpose, we can discuss some points or some factors we can discuss. These are the factors on which we would say that the form electrical energy is more superior than the other form of energy. These factors are convenient form, easy control, better flexibility, cheapness, cleanliness, and high transmission efficiency. Now we discuss one by one. First is convenient form. Convenient form means we can convert electrical energy into another form very easily. For example, we can convert electrical energy into light energy in the terms of bulbs, fluorescent tubes, etc. We can convert electrical energy into heat in the form of heaters, water heaters, and other forms. We can convert the electrical energy into mechanical energy such as motors. Okay. Next is easy control. That means the electrical power of energy can be controlled very easily. If we want to control a motor, electrical motor, then if we want to control it on and off by using only one switch, we can control the supply of electrical energy. If we are pressing on button, the supply will continue. If we are pressing off button, supply will be low. Similarly, if we want to control the stroke motor by varying the resistance, we can control the speed of a particular motor. That means the electric energy supplied to the motor is varied by varying the resistance. And with that, we can turning on or turning off the motor by operating the switch. Next one is better flexibility. Better flexibility means we can easily transmit the electric power from one place to another with the help of converter. So its transmission is or transportation is easy. It is quite flexible. Because generating plants are at different place and locality or load is at different place, then easily can be transmitted to the conductors and towers, etc. Cheapness. The production and utility or applications to the cheapness belongs to the consumption of money and other factors. So we can say it is quite cheap than the other forms of energy. Next, cleanliness. As we all know that electrical energy does not provide or release the smoke, fumes, and other type of hazardous gases. So it keeps the environment clean. So it is another factor that it does not make the noise. Other mechanical other sources make the noise. So we can say this factor cleanliness is satisfied with the electrical energy. Next is high transmission efficiency. As I told you earlier that electrical energy is generated at generating plants that is far away from the locality. The difference in the distance between the load center and generating plant may be hundreds of kilometers. So we have to transmit the power from generating end to the distribution end. For that purpose, we have to use transmission system, and the electrical energy is transmitted through the conductor. When we look at that transmission, then transmission of power from generating end to the load end, and we can check the efficiency, we find that the transmission efficiency of electrical system is very high as compared to the other one. So these are the factors those make the electrical energy superior than the other form of energy. Now we will discuss the topic generation of electrical energy, means how electrical power or electrical energy is generated. As you know that there is one formula called the induced EMF. Generation of electrical power, we go for the dynamic induced EMF. That means the component having rotating part or rotating component that is rotating, and due to that we are getting the rate of change of flux. Another method is static induced EMF. That means the machine where EMF induced is a static device. This concept, static induced EMF concept, is used in the case of transformer. Whereas dynamic induced EMF concept is used in generator. AC generator or alternator as well as magnetic force. system is electromagnetic. Here we are providing DC supply. Here we are providing DC supply to the magnetic force. So what we are getting? We are getting constant flux. When again DC supply, flux of constant magnitude is which is moving from north pole to south pole. Okay? If rotor is stationary, understand? If rotor is stationary, if rotor is stationary, then what will happen? The whole flux with constant magnitude will transfer from north pole to south pole. So what we can say? There is no rate of change of flux with respect to time. What we can say? The amount of there is no change in amount of flux that is moving from north pole to south pole. So in that condition, this is what conductor. Stationary. Here V5 by E B equals to 0, therefore E equals to 0. No EMF is induced. Here no EMF is induced. But what we to generate the EMF or generate the electric energy, what we are requiring, there should be rate of change of flux. That means we have to rotate the rotor. We have to rotate the rotor so that the rotor winding should cut the magnetic flux, and with that there should be rate of change of flux. Now, how we can rotate the rotor? To rotate the rotor, we are requiring one prime mover that is coupled with the alternator shaft or rotor shaft. That means to rotate the rotor of alternator, we are requiring one prime mover. That is mechanic coupled with the shaft of alternator. Now, what we will do? When the prime mover will rotate, it will rotate the alternator also. But how we can rotate this prime mover? How we can rotate the prime mover? the different kind of energy that is available in the environment, or we can say earth, that energy is used to rotate the prime mover, and then when the prime mover is rotated, it will rotate the alternator rotor winding, and that rotor winding will cut the magnetic field, and due to which we will obtain rate of change of flux with respect to time, and even will be induced in the alternator. Okay. This prime mover is also known as turbine. Now, what our prime mover object? Our prime object is to rotate the turbine. Okay. So that we can obtain the electrical energy. There are two kinds of sources through which we can obtain the electrical energy. So conventional sources of energy are water, fuel, and look at here. The conventional sources of electrical energy are water, fuel, nuclear power. With the help of water, or the water and water's energy can be utilized to rotate the turbine. Similar with fuel like coal or diesel, other things can be utilized to rotate the turbine. So that electrical energy can be generated, and similarly nuclear power. By having nuclear reaction, as we know that when atoms drop down, it releases lot of energy. That energy, or that energy is known as nuclear energy, and that energy is utilized to rotate the turbine. How? Simply, nuclear energy releases energy that is used to convert water or coal into steam. That steam hits the turbine blade, and the turbine rotates. Okay. Next, the non-conventional sources of electric energy. It is having sun or solar, then wind, biogas, hydro, etc. But we will concentrate on only conventional sources. now for thermal power plant, I am drawing a simplest diagram so that we can easily understand the process of thermal power plant. How the thermal energy of the coal can be utilized to rotate the turbine so we can obtain the electrical energy. So in the case of thermal power plant, as a component we are requiring in a broad way boiler, condenser, turbine, alternator. Okay? And from outside we are requiring coal and water. So look at this diagram. one first pole is cut out from the other pole, that is 12 and 12 by 8, and then that is sent to the boiler. Then that is sent to the boiler where it is burned. Now here pole is burned. At the same time we are feeding water through the water feed pump to the boiler. Then the due to the burning of coal, the coal heat energy is transmitted into the water, and now water is converted into steam. Okay, then this steam is transmitted to the turbine, and with the help of one nozzle, that steam, that basically that steam is rising by some other means. We convert that steam into a dry steam. Okay, because if there are some water moisture component or content is there, that will affect the turbine blade. Okay, so this is the very important thing. This is the dry steam that is ending in the turbine. When that steam hits the turbine blade, turbine rotates, and as we know that we can see this turbine is connected or mechanically coupled with the alternator. The alternator rotates. Since we are having here constant magnetic field, so rate of change of flux occurs, and EMF is induced or EMF is obtained at this big terminal. Since it is mentioning as filter alternator, see our output terminals are there. Now that steam is coming out after getting to the turbine blade. That steam comes out and sending to the condenser, where it gets goes cooled down. So again this steam is converted into water, and with the help of water pump again it is sending back to the boiler, and this process goes continuous and continuous and continuous. Okay, regular. Now in a aerospace, understand the chemical energy that is existing in the coal, that is given to the water, and now the water is converted into the steam. What we can say, the chemical energy of the coal is converted into heat by burning the coal. Okay, and that heat is given to the water, and water is converted into steam. That steam provides mechanical energy to the turbine, and this mechanical energy is used to rotate the rotor. So electrical energy is produced. This is a general diagram of thermal power plant. Hydropower plants are the plants where the water is used to generate the electrical energy. Okay. Or we can say in the hydropower plant, water is used to rotate the turbine. Similarly, in the thermal power plant, the coal energy that is converted into steam is used to rotate or drive the alternating turbine.
This one has a thermal power plant, one thermal power plant diagram is a
simplified diagrams of the different power plants. Okay, now look at this. For the hydropower plant, what we have to do? We have to collect the water reservoirs by forming the dams. This is the dam structure, so we can collect water here, and with the help of penstock, the water is sent to the water turbine with a huge speed. So that through that penstock, the potential energy of water is converted into kinetic energy, because when this water hits the turbine blade rotates, so the potential energy of water is converted into the kinetic energy, and then the turbine is rotating, which is mechanically coupled with the generator. So generator rotates and which induces the EMF. Okay, and this water is through another pipe of this water is discharged in the downstream. Okay, this is a general concept of hydropower plant. Now, in this way, we can understand the potential energy of water converted into the kinetic energy, and this kinetic energy is used to rotate the rotor of generator, so electrical energy obtained. In the next class, we will discuss some other topics on that content. Thank you.